of an unusual situation. It's not like it's a fourth quarter do or die. They went for it, didn't get it. We'll see how that affects them this go around.
Partner, I'm wondering if we're starting to see the effects of analytics coming into play here, where people are studying the number of possessions, how many times you should go for it, what position it leaves your team in. Maybe we're starting to see a little bit of that creeping into the NFL game.
Yeah, I think we've seen it in other sports, maybe into the NFL now as well. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. The Philip Dorsett hauls it in, and he's brought down after a good gain. A really nice gain of 25 yards. From midfield, here's Brady. Oh, he can't get away, and Brady will go down.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon, and guess what? I think they're just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield and get after the quarterback. It's
been such an impressive first half to get that lead. Now Brady looking middle, and it's incomplete. Gronkowski, the intended target, and that takes us from second to third down.
I would say it'd probably be a good idea for him to reintroduce himself to his receivers at the half because they're definitely on different wavelengths. But I also don't advocate waiting that long. Next series, before you get out there, hey, let's get together, guys. Let's get this thing moving.
On third and long, it's Brady. And this is going to be incomplete. TJ Carey right there in coverage. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
And definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
White 20! White 20, Alpha! 54! Here we go!
They'll try and throw for it here. And the Browns' pressure gets to him that time, and he's going to go down. Boy, a real head-scratcher there. And the Browns are going to get this thing back. Excellent field position. First and 10, Mayfield. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. A good pickup there, 26 yards. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back to Foxborough after this.
No. Check. Patriot. All right, now, Lucky 56.
A first down carry here for Johnson. And he's brought down. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And Charles, when you catch that toss going right or left, really, but right in this instance, do you go straight for the pylon? Is that where you're going?
Well, typically you want to try and maneuver people a little bit so you have some space to get to the pylon. So I want to make sure I try and move them a little bit to the inside, and in this case to the left, so I can get to the right side and get to that pylon and wink at it as I go by.
Returnable for Dorsett. And now out come the Patriots. And last time, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. We'll see if they can pick themselves up off the mat and do better this go around.
Sometimes I have this vision of coaches writing notes to themselves before a game. And sometimes that note says, be aggressive, stay aggressive. Maybe that's what we saw in the last possession.
Yeah, they were very aggressive. This time, will it result in points? We'll find out.
By 20! By 20!
On first and 10, here's Brady. Goes right side, complete to Gronk. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 18 big yards on that one, and a New England first down. Brady now on first down. Oh, he can't get away, and Brady will go down. Myles Garrett in there to get him. His second sack now in the afternoon. Brady to throw on second down. Over the middle, complete. That's Gordon. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. He got 29 yards that time.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there? Yeah. Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
First down, Brady. Caught on the right side by Dorsett. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And this is picked up by the Browns.
Baby, could you? I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you sent right now. I got too much on my mind right now. Tell that hero Dale, get my baby 35. That's, I swear, baby, it was just kissing. That's it. How could I forget that you done done for me? Baby, gonna take the charge and take the fall for me. Would love to take you shopping, but girl, I'm in your town. Sorry, little mama, I can give you more. Baby, could you? I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you sent right now. I got too much on my mind right now. Tell that hero Dale, get my baby 35.
Gotta hit him on the jack. When you coming back, where's you at on the mat? Everything is intact. Could've been a seamstress, still wouldn't cut him slack. Pretty much ain't got a clue. Itty bitty piggyback off everything I do. But I'm still dropping. Got him looking like James Harden at the awards. Back to you, I'm so into you. For real, bread like I'm keen to you. If you were 10, I add 10 to you. They be mad when I 10 to you. That's what the bay like. Call me Buffy, cause that's what I slay like. These, I sun them like it's daylight. These, wanna know what it's like. What it's like, yo, what it's like, yo. They wanna know what it's like, yo. All this ice is like snow. Get kimonos and let's fly to Tokyo. Pretty, pretty, please, baby. Won't you cop this for me?
I got too much on my mind right now. I ain't got the time to get you sent right now. I got too much on my mind right now.
Rodeo, get my baby 30,000.
It's one of them ones, man. We just in the car, man. It's like when you in the car, you just think about everything, man. Definitely when you like you by yourself and you just cruising on the highway, man. Yeah, this got me thinking. On that cap, swerving through traffic, listening to trap. My windows ain't tinted, so notice me. Four braids, Yankee fitted, yeah, know it's me. I'm everywhere comfortable, but I'm still attentive. A young with money will make offended. I ain't flashy, I'm classy, but I ain't stupid either. Never show up to that's hungry and eager. My brother's keeper, I'm loyal, it's all in my demeanor. A true believer, I believe when they didn't believe her. That's why I don't let opinions affect me. I do what I wanna do. If they do or they don't accept me, they expect me to give up. I almost did. Things went from moving fast to slow motion. I was losing focus, stuck on that. It was smooth on the surface, but underneath it was broken. Hoping to find hope in this hopeless world we live in. What you give is what you given. Gotta make wise decisions, gotta stay tunnel vision. Gotta avoid collision, keep scratching the surface and keep your palms itching. Gotta pay moms a visit, it's been a while. I've been working, she keep telling me she miss her child. I find myself passing the house, then I spin around. She say I'm always moving, ma, I just can't sit around. Oh my, cause the cash ain't gon' come to us. When we was down, who gave a dime or gave a for us? So instead of making it hard, I made it fun for us. Make it easy, so when you need it, you just run to us. But it's a lot of pressure, I'm trying to stick and move through this. Fixing these bumps on the road so I can just cruise through this. Living my life on the road, I'm trying to get used to this. And when they throw dirt, I just act like a broom to this. Trying to stay true to this. Even when they lie on me, world on my shoulders, my girl can't even cry on me. God watching over me, the devil probably spy on me. I've been going through some, Kenneth keep an eye on me. I know it's been a drought, but to my fans, don't go dry on me. If you want a picture, take a picture, don't get shy on me. I'm here to inspire, I admire that you admire me. I've been in the dark, but I promise you'll see a brighter me. I'm sorry. To all my supporters, man, I love y'all. I just want to say thank you for supporting me since day one. You don't want to see me win, man. I don't know why, but we gonna win anyway. I came straight out the with a microphone. Boy, I swear I couldn't leave that mic alone. Everybody clear the room, I like to write alone. I'm in my zone, bass bouncing off the styrofoam. I'm never in between, I'm either hot or cold. Can't be a loser, I maneuver like I got a clone. I'm out here in these streets like I ain't got a home. And you barely hear from me like I ain't got a phone. Because there's no days off, there's no days off. I know it sounds a little painful, but it pays off. Social sites was distracting, so I stayed off. Spoke to God, then me and Satan had a face off. I swear my life was like a rocket, then it takes off. First I plotted, then I got it, couldn't wait long. I put the pedal to the metal, then took the brakes off. And I kept an A1 like the steak sauce. My paychecks used to be a pair of Jordans, and I know I can't afford them, but I went ahead and bought them. Then I quit, started, spent my money on recording. Yeah, the studio was small, but man, that made me a fortune. Made me a fortune, man. Trying to stop me. Y'all can't stop me. This is forever. Forever, man. I mean that.
Thank you. Hop out, valet, walk out. All these bins I lost count, cause I'm too up right now. Too up right now. I'm too on one day on my third. I was too broke, now I'm too rich. Made 100K on my third shift. I'm a boy, so boy, and I'm a gangster. And you a boy. Man, we been getting money for a long time. We was out here hungry for a long time. I don't never really had no punch lines. And all you rappers looking like a lunch line.
Ooh. Right now, I got you. Right now.
Nothing. Need a Uber. Right now. Right now. Need crew love. Right now. Cause we two up. Right now. Ooh. I'm up right now. Hop out, ballet, walk out. All these bands I lost count, cause I'm too up right now. Too up right now. Yeah, I'm too up. Round blew up. Copped that new rape on them haters. Threw up. Brought them, went to jail for them. Told me you up. First time I seen 100 bands, yeah, I grew up. Ooh, on the couch with my shoe up. And we was getting that record label money before they knew us. And we were blowing your budget in the club to the booth up. If your dog follow your ball hog and get your whole crew up. Ooh, I'm with right now, I got you. Right now, nothing. Need a Uber right now. Right now, need crew love right now. Cause we two up right now. Ooh, I'm up right now. Hop out, ballet, walk out. All these bands I lost count, cause I'm too up right now. Too up right now.
Bring out the Brinks truck, I'm young, flying.
Just off the shores of Lake Erie, we are at First Energy Stadium in a city aptly named after its founder, Moses Cleveland, way back in 1796. This was the scene a few minutes ago. The dog pound in full roar as their Browns emerge from their tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers. Here comes Montgomery now to return it. Down. Oh, he's going to air it, and he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Terrence Mitchell, and he's just across midfield and down at the 49-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Interception, Mayfield. Throw left side, caught by the tight end Njoku. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage.
Green 39! Green 39!
Mayfield now on second down. Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. And their inaugural sack of the game coming from an unlikely source.
You mean it wasn't a linebacker? It wasn't a defensive end?
It was somebody like you.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, that's a surprise for the offense. That's not what they normally get when they think about pressure.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Third and long for Mayfield. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And all the way down to the 10-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. After getting that turnover on the first drive of the game, you'd hate to just stall out the momentum, go three and out. They're able to avoid that there.
Yeah, we talk about complimentary football all the time, but I think it's a little bit deeper than that. Defense went out, forced a turnover, gave the ball to the offense. It's now the offense's.
And he'll score. Touchdown, Browns. Baker Mayfield, a 10-yard touchdown run. And the Browns have taken the early lead. Well, the defensive coverage was good, so good, he just decided to make a play of his own, and it worked out.
Yeah, you often wonder if they think to themselves, was the coverage too good to allow him to run the football? I think you'd rather take your chances with him doing exactly that, and he beat him on that play all the way to the end zone.
CD, as Green Bay files their way back out here for offense, what did you take away from that loss that you called last week against Washington?
Wouldn't be surprised if they run the ball a little bit more in the future, try to help out Aaron Rodgers and his knee. Ty Montgomery, he's the number two back. The number one guy, Jamal Williams. And right now, number three is Aaron Jones, but he could rise up because he's so explosive. But it's a guy.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he takes this down deep into Cleveland territory. It's a big play there for Green Bay. 61 yards.
All right. Jump out.
Now a play fake here on first down. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers. And nothing there on the return. They've got the football, but they'll have to start this drive at their own 4-yard line. Scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Really shouldn't be a surprise. It's going to be hard to move people in this situation. You know they're going to bring the pressure defensively. Because I remember playing in these spots, and my coaches always say, don't be afraid to try and create a safety, too. They're going to bring pressure.
Handoff comes to Hyde. And he'll take this up to about the 7 or 8 yard line. 4 yards on the pickup there as they get it back to a more manageable third and seven.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
It looks like the Packers have added an extra DB on third down.
Over!
On the toss, here's Johnson. And some room to work. And he will have the first down as he's up to his 17-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. Well, after an interception, last thing you want to do is go three and out, give the ball right back. They avoided that.
Yeah, you definitely do not want to do that. I remember in college I played with a really big-time player on defense. We ended up getting an interception as we passed the offense coming out. He told him, if you don't take care of this football, you have to answer to me later. You definitely want to take care of it, pick up first downs.
First down, Mayfield. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Higgins. And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. And he takes it down deep into Green Bay territory. A big play there on the catch and run. 66 yards. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
Leopard! Leopard!
Four down, check, check. Hey, watch 85. Watch 85.
Now let's go. Blue 90. Blue 90. All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky.
Now Mayfield. Under pressure, and he'll go down. They'll sack him on what ought to be the final play of this first quarter. Clay Matthews in from his linebacker spot. He's able to drop him for a loss of about 10. Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. The Browns with a football to begin quarter number two. They're in the midst of a nice drive, but facing a third and long here. Quarterback, you know, maybe that's just an example of a growing pain for him.
I think you're right about that, because when the game starts to move fast and it moves quickly on him, a lot of times they fall back on what they know best, their arm. He's slinging it on this one. Had a wide open target, but didn't have the proper footwork to increase his accuracy.
So chalk that down as an 8-play drive capped with a field goal.
Yeah, as a friend of mine used to say, they were moving and grooving for a while, but they couldn't keep the momentum going enough to get a touchdown out of it.
Now the Packers get set to go. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
And left side here, it's Graham. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Caught on the right side by Adams. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he ran.
And he's taken down. This will be a Brown sack. Emmanuel Ogba in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
Rodgers to Cobb. Good for a Green Bay first. From midfield, here's Rodgers. Got a man over the middle, it's Williams. He got 29 yards that time. Well, this is how you shake the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4-for-4.
Watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when, who told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions in a row, I'm going to stay confident, keep flinging it. I just figured there's something wrong with the football.
Rodgers to throw once more. And that is incomplete here.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync. Only way to play good defense.
He's going to get it running right. And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line. He lost four there, and it's third down.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been. And he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown. Jimmy Graham, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Packers have cut it back within a score. And he's got it up and through. Crosby on now to kick it away. To return, it's Peppers. And he's all the way up across the 40 and down at the 42-yard line. Great return.
Any return that gets you to midfield is a great return. One first down, and you're almost in field goal position.
Good starting field position for him as they come up first and 10. The gun, Mayfield. And he's going to be wrapped up and driven down.
My, oh my, they've had some success bringing him off the edge. How about the gambling man who's the defensive coordinator? He's not just bringing pressure. He's bringing a corner to go after the quarterback.
And it's worked twice now, twice like a charm.
And not only has that worked like a charm, he's been awfully disruptive in his usual role covering receivers. Now he's rushing the passer as well.
Now a second down throw for Mayfield. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. The Browns on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This time they face a third and two. Working out of the gun, Mayfield being chased out left. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
And I feel like my man, Old Mo, momentum might be changing jerseys right now. How about what they just got done? They scored a touchdown their last drive. Now here's a 3-and-out. Maybe momentum's getting ready to creep to the other sideline.
The offense staying out. They're going to go on fourth and two. Fourth down, Mayfield. He rifles one that's intercepted. Kevin King with a pick. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
So after the INT, it's Rodgers. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
Another dangerous throw there, partner. I mean, he's already thrown two interceptions here in the first half. I don't know if you want to keep throwing up 50-50 balls and you've had that kind of lack of success.
Absolutely. And he's going to be grabbed and pulled down. Christian Kirksey in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them.
Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. And now a timeout called defensively by the Browns as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. And that will knot us up at 10. The bottom line, tremendous starting field position, really squandered there as they wind up going backwards and then come up with just three.
Well, getting the three turned out to be important. I can imagine the head coach, when he ordered the field goal, please salvage something out of this drive. That was not fun to watch.
The Browns offense heading back out to take possession. Interception. He'll look to throw. That is caught by the former Gator Antonio Callaway. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. We call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. Mayfield now from the 50. To the right side, and he's got Landry complete. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here, as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. This quarterback now 6 of 10 in this first half. He's got his guys a first down here.
Detroit! Detroit!
Play fake. Mayfield. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Going to the air again with Mayfield. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete. This secondary has been roasted in this first half, and they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're going to need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back, but that's one step in the proper direction.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense, as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. And his kick is good. And they will take the lead at 13-10. Now the drive ends in just three, but they'll take it. Looks like they'll head to the locker room, barring something unfortunate in front on the scoreboard.
Yeah, they may not be jumping up and down and celebrating because they have the lead, but still, any little momentum in a game like this is important to a team, and they'll feel real good about going in and regrouping, knowing that they are out in front.
And he is out of bounds, able to get it across the 20-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They go play action here on first down. He's going to wind up and air it out. And that's caught inside the 30. And he takes this down deep into Cleveland territory. A big play there just before halftime. 63 yards. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Browns are going to get the second half kickoff, and they've got this lead as well as we are back and underway. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. Ha ha, Clinton Dix there for the stop.
Back at 99 Philly, here we go. All right now, lucky 56, lucky 56. Patriot. Gone. Go, lucky 56, lucky 56. Green 39.
Second down, Mayfield. That's complete over the middle to Callaway. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. The Browns on third down, 2 for 5
Detroit,
to this point.
Detroit.
This is third and four. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. That's Njoku over the middle. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 63 yards receiving for him now, and that last catch good enough for a first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. He'll pick up another first down with that run.
And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Detroit.
Mayfield. Flush to his right. Looking for the out route. It's completed to Landry. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down. A little risky there when you roll out of that pocket right like he did. You complete the pass, but you don't get anything out of it.
But how many times have we seen when a quarterback exits out of the pocket, doesn't matter if they go left or right, the defense loses its leverage, right? There's a little chaos back there, and receivers come open. Great discipline on that play. They didn't let that happen and held it to no gain.
Detroit! Over!
On third down, Mayfield. He's got his man, that's Landry. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield, but when you can pick it up in big chunks, and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Jarvis Landry from 4 yards out. And the Browns add on to their lead. It's good, and it's 21-10. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Here comes Montgomery now to return it. Oh, good footwork on the spin. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Here's the Packers offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw it.
And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown, Packers. Randall Cobb, 78 yards. And the Packers are back within a score. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
Oh, he's got a little daylight. And it'll be an excellent return as he's all the way down inside the 25-yard line.
Well, whatever the relationship was between the special teams and the offense, it's gotten a heck of a lot closer after a return like that. The special teams keep setting them up. The offense thinks they'll go out there and knock them down.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19. 3-19.
They'll try to get the offense going with Johnson. And he'll at least get him inside the red zone here, down to about the 19. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. Mayfield now on 2nd down. Fires quickly here, and that's complete. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. And we're back now here in Cleveland. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point, just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the 4th quarter. So 1st and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. They'll run it now out of the gun. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal. And in this situation with the lead 4th quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
They try to throw on 2nd down, but this one is incomplete. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up 3rd down.
We got 3. Now let's go. Blue line.
Gone.
Blue line.
Detroit.
Now Mayfield on 3rd and goal. Buying time to his left. And that is incomplete.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. So they get the 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now because they'd feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction. All of a sudden, they're down. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. 1-play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. 1-play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
On 2nd down, Williams. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big 3rd down. Working from the gun, Rodgers. He's going to dump that off to his running back, Montgomery. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. It's an 8-yard pickup, and that's going to bring up a 4th down.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Now Rodgers got to have this one. Open man is Allison, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Fourth down, no problem. 19 yards that time, and now it's first and 10. Rodgers now 11 to 15 through the air. Here's first and 10. Now it's Rodgers. It's caught here by Adams. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Back to throw. They'll set up the screen to Montgomery. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
Oh, I know it goes against the grain here. It totally goes against it, but you've got to drop the ball in that situation. He makes a catch, but he loses yards and doesn't get out of bounds.
So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. Back to throw. He's going to let it fly. That is caught by Cobb. And it's a Packer touchdown. Randall Cobb, his second touchdown of the night. And the Packers are an extra point away from taking the lead. Crosby on now to kick it away. To return, it's Peppers. And he'll have good starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
They practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases,
and he can't get a throw away. He's taken down.
Brandon, that's just football 101. If you're out of the pocket, you've got to get rid of the football in this situation. You cannot take a sack in a two-minute drill.
Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle.
All right, now, lucky 56, lucky 56, 319, 319, gone, 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 gone.
He's back to throw. And this is complete on the comebacker. It's Landry. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game.
Now let's go. Green, gone, gone. Green, gone, gone. Gone, gone. Gone, gone.
He'll look to throw. He's got an open man. He completes it to Callaway. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Over, 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 over. Leopard, Leopard.
They'll run it with Johnson. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. And now the Packers going to take another timeout. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
Over, over, Leopard, Leopard. Gone, 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 gone.
They'll look to throw. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow, wow. And that was an impressive drive. But I think we're going to talk about being way more impressive because of who led them. A rookie quarterback in that spot, putting his team in front, that's big league.
Gone, 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 gone,
try and run for it with Johnson. And he will get into the end zone for the 2 points. And that helps. That gives him a 7-point lead. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll put it out to the 25. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat and mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring, and how much pressure can the offense handle?
We're going to find out. To throw, it's Rodgers. Caught left side by Cobb. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. 88. Back to throw, Rodgers. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Myles Garrett in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. One final try now for Rodgers. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both